to write something and read it because I have to deliver this in 5 minutes because we're running short of time. For the last third of a century, politics, especially in Britain and America, has been dominated by a set of ideas that can best be summed up in Margaret Thatcher's famous and poisonous one-liner, "There's no such thing as society." This political philosophy has a long history running through people like Frederick Hayek and Ayn Rand. Ayn Rand, who, by the way, is the big inspiration for a lot of Silicon Valley people, who memorably said, "If any civilization is to survive, it's the morality of altruism that men have to reject." These ideas grow out of a misunderstanding of Darwinism, out of the idea that competition and inequality and the triumph of the strongest were actually the engines of human progress, and that it was strong individuals who drove human growth, whereas any emphasis on altruism inhibited that. Ayn Rand went so far as to describe altruism as evil. As a matter of fact, Darwin himself never believed any of this. He said so in his book, The Descent of Man. This is a quote from that book. "As man advances in civilization and small tribes are united into larger communities, the simplest reason would tell each individual that he ought to extend his social instincts and sympathies to all members of the same age and nation, though personally unknown to him. This point being once reached, there's only an artificial barrier to prevent his sympathies extending to the men of all nations and races." So it's worth remembering that, because the right wing has always claimed Darwin as their sort of intellectual ancestor, but they obviously didn't read that part of the book. I came from a working class family, my dad was a postman, but I was lucky to have grown up in a different political atmosphere from the one we have now. I inherited a relatively generous social arrangement that was designed, and being designed, to prevent people like me being caught in the poverty trap. These include a free education, the National Health Service, the Dole, and various public services such as the BBC, all of which were critical in my life, particularly the Dole, actually. I couldn't become a musician without national assistance, like many musicians. These institutions were set up and nurtured by people who did believe there was such a thing as society, and who also thought that one of its great rewards was the possibility of people helping each other. They believed it was the benefit of all members of society to ensure that there were as few losers as possible, and that we all benefit from the flourishing of each one of us, and that we all suffer from any individual failures. Over the last 30 years, those ideas have become very unfashionable. We've been told that the invisible hand is much more intelligent than we can ever be, that all our attempts to improve society will only make matters worse, that governmental design of social arrangements would inevitably result in totalitarianism and the crushing of the individual. Communism is always cited as the proof of this. However, as the writer Octavio Paz once said, communism may have been the wrong answer, but it was the right question. But that question, can we design a better future, is no longer being asked. Instead, we have nauseating phrases like UK PLC, which is the idea that we should run our country as a business and give up on all those silly pinko ideas of social mobility and a better world. Just get the business right. That means don't constrain capitalism in any way at all, and the rest will look after itself. By some utterly mysterious means, this is supposed to deliver a wonderful life for the maximum number of people. What's good for General Motors is good for America. I think it's this bundle of naive ideas that Jeremy Corbyn's supporters, that's us, want to reject. Exist to serve the interests of people, not the other way around. It means they believe that human potential can be better realized by building more inclusive social structures than by some misunderstood quasi-religious law of the jungle Darwinism. I believe this is what support for Corbyn represents. The return to an idea that politics should be about designing society to work for as many of its members as possible, and the idea that we can't leave this to some automatic, semi-mystical, invisible hand. We have to get together and think about it and design it and experiment and make it work, all of us. This is what we have to think about. This is what we have to get across over the next few years, that all of us have to take back the right to design the world we live in and not accept having it designed for us by a small elite with a daft and selfish philosophy.